Zenless Zone Zero about the recent 1.3 developer live stream. This one has tons of information about the new characters Yanagi and Lighter, which are both coming in version 1.3, as well as lots of information about upcoming features and some hints about Miyabi too. So I want to take advantage of this time to talk to you about their skills, their potential placement in your teams, and whether you should pull for them immediately or whether you should keep saving for that Miyabi like I'm considering. Now, before I continue, I want to tell you about this very important redemption code that you can use in-game. It gives you 30,000 dennies, 300 polys, and some other goodies too. It's Virtual Revenge, and it's only valid until tomorrow. So make sure to use this ASAP when you see this video. Alright, so going back to what we were talking about with this new patch, of course they've been showing a lot of Lighter, as well as a good amount of Miyabi, and some of the new modes that you can see. I'll be making a separate video that you can find here on the channel, and that'll be discussing what I think about some of these modes, which they all look very awesome, as well as what I think they might add to your strategy, and maybe if you consider building some characters, hint hint, Caesar, for some of those upcoming events. But first off, of course, I want to talk about the new characters, and I'm going to start with Yanagi. Of course, we have the good fortune of seeing that on the live stream, they have shown us some of her skills, so let's check out that part of the video right now. Okay, so this part of the video, they have a little combat showcase of what some of her skills can do. And we have seen some of the content creators already play her on the beta servers, and she's very excellent so far. So if you're into the idea of playing another anomaly character, I know we just had several of them so far, but if you're into that idea, then she's looking pretty good. She also has a stance switch that powers her up and lets her do different things too, which is pretty awesome. You can kind of see the stance switch gauge on the top.
Simply put, as long as you keep a good rhythm of switching her stances, Yanagi can continuously receive the buffs from both stances. Also,
that's pretty cool.
After Yanagi switches her stance, every time she deals damage with a basic attack, her anomaly buildup increases.
So that's her extra skill. She's also got something cool where when she tags in after an anomaly has been triggered, she gets extra damage too, which is pretty nice. Overall, the main thing about this character is that obviously she's going to be extremely damaging. They don't show you the damage numbers in this, but we've already seen some of what the damage looks like on the beta server. She's got good percentages. They might nerf a thing or two, but probably not. They're probably just going to leave her the same, I think. I think the main thing... There we go. This is the main combat showcase that I want you guys to see. The main thing about this character is that if you already have Grace on your account, then it's real hard for me to tell you, hey, you know, you should go, especially if you have your Grace built up. You've got a level 60 Grace with a W engine. She's got skills leveled up and everything. It gets really hard for me to recommend this character at that point because she's doing... She plays point more often, but she's doing kind of the same job as Grace.
Activating her ultimate, only intense focus as she lets loose a flurry of deadly slashes.
If you don't have Grace, this character's amazing. You want an electric damage dealer? She's ham. We don't have a lot of good electric damage dealers either right now, so that helps too.
A gentle person. She only becomes that serious when things get real.
Anyway, overall, I think that her skill set is very interesting if you're already invested into Anomaly. It also gives you the potential to have two different Anomaly teams. So, you know, a lot of people on their accounts, they have two different stun teams. Well, guess what? If you got Yanagi and you got Piper and you got Grace and you got, you know, Jane Doe and you got Bernice, well, you know, after a while, you start looking at those characters and you got, you know, multiple teams that you can make out of that. And she can help contribute to that, too. So if you're really deep in Anomaly on your account, then she might be strong. I would say one thing that I worry about and to watch out for is they've been giving us a lot of good anomaly agents kind of in a row. So I do worry if they're going to create some type of enemies that have heavy anomaly resistance or something like that. We haven't really seen that so far, but just a thing to be cautious of and a thing that I worry about too. Then again, sometimes with the stun comps, it's pretty tough. I'm going to forward to the part of the video now, everyone, that features more information about Lighter so we can talk about him a bit. Actually, I didn't have to forward very far because it was literally the next part of the video. But his idea is that he's a fire stunner, and he's also good at buffing fire, as well as he buffs ice. Is it ice or is it electric? They're going to show us in the kit. He buffs two sets, I know that.
He certainly stands out in the crowd. But truth be told, Letter's not one to hog the spotlight.
And of course, he uses his fists in combat.
His animations look freaking awesome.
Lighter faces his enemies head on in close range combat. And when his morale is high enough,
he also gives himself extra impact, which is really nice.
So turns him into an enhanced.
This is the thing with all the good stunner agents. They all can buff their own impact somehow. Even Caesar can buff her impact temporarily.
His attacks also reduce the target's fire and ice resistance and makes them stunned longer.
The JoJo's, hell yeah. Man, he looks really awesome. The main thing is that he's got kind of the same problem as Miyabi, which is that if you really like, you know, if you have Colita already and you like Colita and you're already using her, it's hard to give that up for, you know, a lighter. Especially they're built up, you've invested skills into them, they've got really good discs already. That being said, if you think he looks cool, if you like the idea of having a K-Dash mixed with Unknown as your character, and he's doing burn knuckles, power waves, all types of nonsense, if you're into that idea, then this guy's definitely for you.
And when it's time for his ultimate, Letter slams the ground with a powerful punch, dealing massive damage and dazed.
He also gets powered up completely. He looks awesome. Anyway, let me know what you guys think about the two characters, because I'm pretty curious your thoughts. Right now, I'm very concerned with both these characters that, you know, it's not that they're not replaceable. It's just that there's someone that kind of does what they do already. They're probably better at it. With stunning, you also got Chingy that's kind of, you know, in competition with Lighter. You could have Chingy on one team and maybe Lighter on another team, and that would be awesome. And you have your shield defense for two stunners. But if you've been going for any event characters recently, then you probably are also invested in some type of anomaly team. And he can work on that too, don't get me wrong. He could bump Bernice's damage and all that stuff, which is pretty nice. Versus Chingy is better with like that Yu Yuan style of team, or even like Ellen or something like that. That knockdown into do a lot of damage really fast. She works a little bit better on that type of squad. All right, now also with the discussion about Section 6 and these new Section 6 characters, they've been giving us many, many hints about the new character, Miyabi. And, you know, they've kind of been hinting that, hey, you know, she's Section 6. This Section 6 group all works together, working in the Hollow, and, you know, looking for this virtual revenge, the special program, like they're hyping it up, right? So I would say this is another reason right now to be extremely, extremely cautious and to really, really think about, you know, what you're pulling and why you're pulling it for your account. If you've been playing since day one and you've already got like Ellen and you got a Zhu Yuan and you got a Jane Doe and you got a Caesar, maybe you even got a Bernice, maybe you got almost every, maybe you only missed like one character, you've got all the event characters, you've got all your teams sorted out and good to go, this might be the time. Okay, now I thought it was crazy when the game first came out and people were like, okay, I'm gonna save all my polys and I'm not pulling anything until Miyabi comes. To me, that was nuts. That makes no sense. Of course, there's other cool characters that you want because maybe you want them to work with Miyabi or something like that. But now is the time where the game's hinting really heavily. They're telling you, hey guys, look, she's coming real soon. They've even updated her model in game to make her look a little bit better compared to the old betas and all that good stuff. So they're letting you know now, guys, that this is the time to save if you want to go big on Miyabi. So I'm just giving you guys the warning, all right? If you pull for Lighter and you get a Lighter and you had already two stunners on your squad, you already had a Colita, and then Miyabi comes along and you don't get her, you're going to be really disappointed. And the same thing, if you got a Grace already built up, she's got a weapon, she's got skill, and then you go for your Nagi, you get your Nagi, cool, you know, great. But then when Miyabi comes along, you know, you better make sure you have enough resources saved, and they're only going to give you so much, right? Because they give you X amount per month that you get, whether it's through the quests and through the missions and through the everything else. Anyway, guys, you let me know what you think and if you're going to pull for either of these two characters or if you're going to save. I personally am strongly considering saving, and that's partly because I still haven't even reached my 300 pulls on the regular banner yet. So if I really wanted a fire stunner, I could just go for like Colita probably. I'm sure that Lighter would be better than Colita, but, you know, not so much astronomically better that it's going to be mind-blowing. And then with Yanagi, it's going to be real hard for me to want to pull for this character, considering that, number one, I just got Bernice, and she's really good. And, you know, I already kind of have a good squad for Bernice together with Jane. Yeah, I don't know. This is a tough one for me. You let me know what you think, fellas. Look out for another video soon where I'm going to be talking to you all as well about the new features coming in 1.3 and whether you should build some characters possibly to work with those two. Have a nice day, everyone. See you later.